Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Fallout New Vegas. Boy, this has been a long time coming. Not really, sort of. I don't know. It depends how you look at it. You could say it's been a long time coming because I haven't uploaded any videos in a long time, so I'm gonna try to get back into it with this. Or, if you'd prefer, you could say, well, it hasn't been that long since you finished Fallout 3. It's kind of inevitable you're gonna do this. And yes, it was, because this is currently my favorite Fallout game. So I figure, basically, this is just to help me get back into it. I've got other stuff I plan to do eventually, but for the moment, I'm gonna be doing Fallout New Vegas because it's a really good game and it's my favorite Fallout. And I have played all of them now. I remember back when I was playing Fallout 3 for a while, I played Fallout 1 for the first time, like while I was in the middle of doing that Fallout 3 playthrough, and I talked about it and compared a few things between them, but I had pointed out that I had never played Fallout 2. Well, after finishing that Fallout 3 playthrough, in the months since then, I have played Fallout 2 as well, to completion, and from what I hear, a lot of people. Or, I mean, sorry, that was a weird way to phrase it. Before I played Fallout 2, I've heard a lot of people say that Fallout New Vegas is sort of a poor man's Fallout 2. I would disagree. I do believe personally that Fallout New Vegas is the better game. But point is, anyway, there'll probably be comparisons throughout this playthrough. But just so you know, I don't dislike Fallout 1 and 2 at all. I think they're both amazing games. But I'm playing this one first because I like it more and it's easier to record. So, yeah. Starting a new game. This will overwrite your autosave. Yeah, whatever.
Atomic fire consumed the Earth. Those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion region did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene.
The face of the guy on the right always just, it looks ridiculous in this cutscene. 18
carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
Yeah. Dude's just having the time of his life over there, rocking back and forth with his shovel in his hands, huge smile on his face, eyes wide like he's high on something. Probably is, because he's a great con. They're always high on something, but, you know, whatever. Anyway, so that's the opening of Fallout New Vegas that just about everybody in the world has seen like 10 times now, but there you go, you can watch it an 11th time, because I don't skip cutscenes in my LPs. Oh, courier stash. Enable all and then disable all, because I believe, I don't know if they ever fixed it, but I think there's a glitch with this mod where if you don't press any of these buttons, you just immediately press done, it actually has them all enabled by default, but it shows them as being disabled, so whatever. So I just did that real quick. So yeah, I've got a lot of mods installed in this. I might do a separate, oh yeah, I didn't actually want this one installed. Fuck me. Okay. Shall be better now. Sorry for the awkward cut there. So there was a mod I had. It's a kind of goofy mod that I've used before that basically introduces like a cover-based stealth mechanic, so you can press a button on your keyboard to like move the camera over, but it's really wonky and janky looking when you do it. So I don't I use the mod like sometimes when I'm just sort of playing around with it, really, but I don't want to actually do a full playthrough with it. I think it would not look good in this LP that I'm trying to do, and also it changes the way stealth boys work and everything like that, so I don't want to mess with it, so I had to uninstall that mod. There will be a couple other awkward cuts coming very soon in this video, unfortunately, but for now, this is the Deus Ex weapon spread mod. Basically, this changes the way that weapon spread works in the normal vanilla game. Weapon spread is sort of randomized, where if you have really low gun skill, your gun will be just arbitrarily less accurate, and at higher gun skills, it'll be more accurate, but there will always be like a minimum amount of spread, so the bullets will go in random directions. This mod is fantastic. It changes it so that your gun is always 100% accurate, but in Jensen mode, it gets less accurate if you are shooting while moving. And in Denton mode, either one of them, it does that, as well as the lower your gun skill is, the weapon will actually, your character's hand will actually move around. They won't be able to hold the gun steady. And once you hit 100 gun skill, then the mod will, their aim will be perfectly accurate and it won't wobble around at all. So I actually really like this mod. I'm gonna go with Denton mode light, which basically is half as punishing as Denton mode. It still has the wobble, but it's not as much wobble. So
oh, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now.
Why yeah.
Just relax a sec. Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Yeah. So the Denton mode light basically is just like half as much wobble as Denton mode. So it's not going to be as wobbly while I have really low gun skill. And I'm basically just doing that because for the purposes of this LP, I don't want to be dying constantly or missing a bunch of shots and looking like a dumbass. So we're gonna try to tone down the difficulty a little bit compared to what I would do normally if I was playing the game by myself. Yeah, that's my name. Welcome to Good Springs. Thank you.
I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place.
Okay, so yes, this is where we're going to design our character, and you may have noticed I named my character Edern, which is a bit of a weird name. I will admit that for sure. But basically, I'd planned in this build to use the two perks. One is for same gender, one is for different gender. The ones that give you extra damage against humans, and also they give you extra dialogue options. And I counted it up. I looked at a list of all the different extra dialogue options that they give you, all the different effects that they have, and female characters actually get, like, three more extra things affected by those perks in total. If you take both of the perks, they get, like, three more special events or whatever that they can do. There you go, there's the hair that I want. So, yeah. I chose to go with a female, and since I'm taking a female character, in order to have the most, most dialogue options, because I am going with a dialogue-heavy playthrough, just to warn you all, I decided to name her after a roleplay character that I've done in a lot of other RPGs, including a couple pen-and-paper ones, named Edern, who is named after a location from the Witcher series. And, basically, nothing special about her, except she is a kleptomaniac, and the actual personality of the character changes depending on what game I'm playing and stuff like that. And this, I'm going to actually be doing a relatively good character, except for the whole kleptomaniac thing. I'm going to be stealing everything in sight, because that's just what I like to do. But anyway, as I mentioned, with the awkward cut where I had to go and... Yeah, I'll walk down to the end of the room. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Sure. Okay. Take it slow now. It ain't a race. Yep, don't want to hurt myself and all that. Yeah, but there's going to be another awkward cut here because, woohoo, look at this. We got a mod configuration thing that I got to mess with. I'm going to have to just change the settings of some things before we get started. So, be back in 1 minute. Okay, and we're back. And as you can see, I've got... Ooh, my HUD's a bit changed, though ironically during this point of the game you don't normally have a HUD until you've done with everything with Doc Mitchell. Yep, looking good so far. Uh-huh. Alrighty. Now we're just gonna skip to the end of this here. All the way back past strength, perception, endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck. All them specials that we're so familiar with. Alright, gonna put strength 6, endurance 6, intelligence at 6, and agility at 7. We're gonna be increasing several of those with implants later on, but for now, that should be. Actually, let me check my notes real quick just to make sure I'm getting all that correct, because I don't have to restart this shit again. Yep. Yep. Okay, that's all good.
Yeah, that's a pretty standard score there, but after what you've been through, I'd say that's great news. Well, we know the fighters are good, but that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter than a bighorn dropping. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking.
I'm already sitting. Get your ass over here, old man. I'm sorry, that's rude. You've been kind to me.
All right. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog.
Dog, cat. House, shelter. Night, campfire.
Enemy.
Enemy, bribe.
Light.
Light, dark.
Mother.
Mother, caretaker.
Okay, now I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one. Conflict just ain't in my nature.
Strongly agree.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
Strongly agree.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
Strongly disagree.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
I don't know.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
No.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
I don't know. Broken chain.
Okay. How about this one?
Woof. Woof.
Last one.
Two bears high-fiving? No? Oh, I don't have that mod installed. I forgot. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. It's not really that great of a mod. A mushroom cloud? Sure.
Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so none of our answers there actually matter. It's basically just, it determines what our tagged skills will be. Now, in the vanilla version of the game, tag skills are kind of stupid, honestly. They don't do much. It's just an instant bonus of 15 points to that skill. Whereas I have modded it to be much more interesting. In Fallout 1 and 2... your tag skills actually mattered, because in those games, when you put a point on a level up into a tagged skill, you got two points actually added to the skill. It had double the effect. So I've done something similar to that here with my Project Nevada settings. Instead, now tag skills give it an instant boost of 5 points, and make it so every point you put into them actually increases the skill by 2. So this makes what skills you choose to tag much more important, because those skills will level up much faster. You'll be getting twice the bonus for them every time you level up and put points into them.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history.
Mm-hmm. And these are our traits. Now, again, normally in the vanilla game, you can only pick 2 traits. I've modded it so you can pick 4. There's mods to make it so you can pick as many as you want, but I think 4 is a nice... it's still restrained enough that you can't go crazy, because I wouldn't ever want to do that personally. I wouldn't want to be able to take every single stupid one, but... I think 2 is a little bit restrictive, but, oh well, whatever. So 4 is fine. I don't even know if I'm going to be using 4. I know I'm going to be using at least 2. Might use 3. But good-natured. You're good-natured at heart, more prone to solving problems with your mind than violence. You gain +5 to barter, medicine, repair, science, and speech, but have -5 to energy weapons, explosives, guns, melee weapons, and unarmed. Basically, this gives you bonuses to all of the, sort of support skills in the game, and, makes you weaker with all weapons. Now, this character that I'm going to be designing is actually going to be deliberately bad with all weapons. So, of course, I'm going to take good-natured. But generally speaking, this trait is actually good for just about any character to take, because even if you plan on, let's say, using energy weapons, you plan from the start to use energy weapons. You make energy weapons one of your tagged skills, and you plan on leveling up and putting tons of points into energy weapons. You're probably not also going to use explosives, guns, melee weapons, and unarmed. I don't think there's a single character build in the entire game who would use all 5 of those skills. Typically, whenever somebody makes a character, you choose 1 weapon type, maybe 2, to level up. But literally every character will use barter, medicine, repair, and most character builds will get some use out of speech. And, some character builds can use science. Science, you have to choose to invest in it and get a high science skill before it starts really being useful. And speech, actually, I suppose speech is the same way, but I think speech is a pretty common one that a lot of people like, but so anyway, point is, at the very least, barter, medicine, and repair. Simply having +5 points in each of those means if you chose, just say, energy weapons, you got a net gain of 10 extra skill points by choosing this perk. Because everybody, literally every character, uses barter, medicine, and repair. If you ever repair a weapon, then you used your repair skill, and having 5 extra points means you repaired for slightly more than you would have without that. If you ever take a stim pack or anything like, or drink any drugs or whatever, then you're using the medicine skill, and you're getting +5 points to that. Even if you never level those skills up and aren't actively building a character around them, you are still getting a +5 point of benefit. And if you ever sell or buy anything, you are getting more use out of your barter skill. Now, this character I'm making, like I said, I'm going to be deliberately bad with every weapon until, like, the end of the game. Then I will be leveling up my gun skill a bit, just so I can use them effectively without them waving around all over the place, like I said, because I have that Deus Ex weapon spread mod. Yeah. So, I'm right here, I'm going to be using medicine, barter, repair, science, and speech. I'm going to be using all of those, so I'm gaining 20 skill points, essentially, by taking this. You know, and I'm only losing 5 on the guns, which I'm not even going to be worrying about until much later in the game. Skilled, similar point. This is good for pretty much everybody to take, because it gives you +5 points to every single skill, but reduces your experience gain by 10%. Now, basically, all this means is that you'll level up slower. You might not reach the maximum level, because there's enough encounters in the game and enough quests, there's enough ways to gain experience that you can easily reach level 50 and with the maximum level and still have quests that you haven't finished, still have areas you haven't gone to, still have new ways of gaining experience. There's more than enough experience gains in the game to eventually level up, even with -10% experience points. So all this does is mean you'll level up slower, but you get more skill points, and you don't have to worry about, you know, possibly not reaching the maximum level. I'm just gonna go take a look over these real quick. Built to Destroy, nope. Claustrophobia, nope. Early Bird, nope. Fast Shot, nope. Four Eyes, this one's quite useful, but I do plan on wearing helmets, basically, so I don't want to be stuck only wearing glasses. Plus, unfortunately, one of the settings that I do have in Project Nevada makes it so whenever you wear a helmet or glasses or goggles of any kind, it puts an actual overlay on the screen to make it more immersive and show you what it's like wearing that that thing. And unfortunately, for wearing normal glasses, the overlay it puts is very, like, grainy and scratched up and really bad looking and really just distracting and kind of annoying, so I don't like that. But normally, Four Eyes is a pretty good trait to take. Heavy-handed, I might take this because I don't plan on upgrading my melee skill at all, but I do plan on using melee weapons for the early game. Because, you know, we're gonna be limited on ammo, but, if we can pick up a pipe and whack stuff with that, then that'd be pretty good. So having just a flat 20% bonus to melee damage is pretty nice, and the -20% crit damage won't really matter. That would only matter if we were going for a melee character who would be putting a lot of points into melee, doing a lot of damage, and, hoping to get critical hits. In this case, since we're doing, you know, low damage anyway because our melee skill is low, that's not really gonna hurt us all that much because the crits will still do more than normal damage. They just won't do that much. But, like, because it's a percentage and we're working with a small number, the amount we're losing isn't that much. But the 20% extra base damage should be pretty useful. Hoarder, no thanks. Hot-blooded, no thanks. Kamikaze, no thanks. We're not going to be using action points anyway because we're just going to be basically playing this like a first-person shooter. I think the only time, and this isn't like I'm trying specifically to do a first-person shooter style playthrough or anything like that. I'm going to be playing this very much like an RPG. That's how I've set up my Project Nevada settings, so that skills and everything matter. And it's your RPG stats and numbers and everything like that. That's how I've got the game set up. That's what the mods I've chosen make the game play like. But with that said, I'm not going to be using VATS a lot because I prefer to just aim and shoot things normally rather than use VATS. The only exception is against like really fast moving enemies. I might use VATS occasionally just to try and take them out before they reach me, like Cazadores and stuff. Logan's Loophole, nope. That's Logan's Loophole is actually a very powerful trait, but only for specific builds built around it. With the intent of using lots of chems and things like that. Nope. Small frame. This one's sometimes useful, but I don't think it'll be useful for our character. No. Trick or Discipline. Nope. And Wild Wasteland. I can't remember. Let's take it, just for the hell of it. Why not? We can always... If I don't like it, I can always use console commands to disable it, probably.
All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Alrighty. Come on, Doc Mitchell. There you go.
Here, these are yours. Was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. But it was just something about a platinum chip. Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. It was my wife's. I think she was about your size, and she hardly wore it after we left the vault. Felt it was too brazen.
Thanks for patching me up.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
I'll try. Yes, we are going to turn on hardcore mode. Ignore the, Ignore that music. That was just basically telling me that this mod is activated. This is an alternate version of the Pip-Boy that, aside from the number 2500, and aside from the fact that it's held in our hand, this basically 99% resembles the whatchamacallit. Oh boy. Oh, yeah, thanks, game. That's just great. Alright, I guess it's gonna give us a tutorial for every single section. No? Okay, maybe not. Oh, most of them, though. Anyway, where's aid? Robco Pip-Boy widget. Yeah, modify field of view. Yes, small, default, large. Let's try large. Bring that back up. There you go, that's a little bit more readable. Anyway. Yeah, this resembles the Pip-Boy from Fallout 1 and 2 that your character uses. In Fallout 1 and 2, I think it's held on the wrist, much like, the normal Pip-Boy 3000 in Fallout 3 and New Vegas, but I could be wrong. Anyway, we're gonna activate this broken submachine gun. We have 25 repair or higher, so we can repair it, and now we've got a free submachine gun. Let's also take Sunset Sarsaparilla. We'll take that for ourselves. Ophthalmoscope, we don't need that. We really don't need most of the stuff in here, but we are going to sneak around and steal everything we can. Like I said, this character is a kleptomaniac. Also, why is my, where's my frickin' crouch button? Where's my sneaky crouch button? Huh. That's weird. Game, what the hell? Controls. Action mapping. Yeah. Block. Left alt. That's a weird thing for block, but okay. Sneak is shift. Oh, right. We have to, like, leave. Oh, God. I really hate the way they do this at the start here. Where you have to, like, leave the building after getting your Pip-Boy before it, like, fully activates all your controls. It's just kind of weird. Watch a loading screen. There you go. Woo! Radio New Vegas signal found. Now we can crouch. Okay, so now let's go back in. Oh, we're also going to get a notification for our Hypatia, right? Any second now. It's another mod I haven't installed. Yeah, a strange radio signal. Among the chatter of the Mojave, your Pip-Boy catches up on an encrypted radio signal. The only discernible information comes from the broadcast signature, which responds to the patronym of Hypatia. You mark down the source on your map. Okay. Now let's just head back inside. And I believe at this point we can bring up our fists too. Yeah, that's something else it locks out. Put those away. So like I said, sneaking around, stealing everything useful. Medical brace, that's not useful. Voice modulator implant, we're not going to be doing that. Drain energy cell, laser pistol, take all those. Radix, Stimpak. Anti-venom. These aren't actually considered stealing. That's interesting. That's kind of funny. But that's part of Project Nevada. It's like the cyberware implants thing. Unfortunately, Medex, nice. Unfortunately, you need to install the cyberware part of Project Nevada in order to be allowed to install the extra options module for Project Nevada. And extra options is all I wanted, so I had to install that. But we will be completely ignoring the implants and pretending they do not exist because they're just stupid. I mean, the goddamn game is easy enough, people. Why do you have to make mods specifically for the purpose of building a completely overpowered character who can destroy everything? And that's basically what the implants are, to the best of my understanding. Alright, just take all this food here. All these empty syringes, no thanks, we don't need those. Okay, empty syringes don't weigh anything, and they can be sold, so actually I am going to take those. Also, I set it to... Wait, shit, I just picked that up without even paying attention. Miscellaneous yeast. No, get rid of that. It's not worth it. I set it to hardcore, but it doesn't feel like hardcore is enabled. None of my, stuff is going up. And... Stimpaks are supposed to have weight in hardcore, aren't they? I thought they were. Well, I know ammo has weight in hardcore, so let me check that. Yeah, I know. Hardcore's not activated for some reason. What the hell, game? I told you to activate the hardcore setting. You frickin'... Hardcore mode off. I selected on! Jesus Christ. Please tell me it's on now. Yes, thank you. I'm pretty sure I selected yes at the start of the game when we walked through that stupid door. Pretty dang sure. I wanted to play this in hardcore mode because hardcore mode is more fun. But whatever. Alright, I think we've taken everything of value, and it's, again, not even considered stealing. Oh yeah, and this is kind of nifty. It's very limited use, but another mod I have installed lets you, like, interact with certain objects in people's homes. One of them being light switches. Or not just objects in homes, but, you know, objects in general. We can turn off every light in Doc Mitchell's house and make it super dark in here. I hope you're enjoying this, Doc Mitchell. I really do. Oh. Must have a medical skill of 50 or higher to examine blood packs. Oh yeah, that's another thing this does. I don't know what this even does. I don't know what the point of examining a blood pack with a microscope... I don't know what that would do, what it would accomplish. But that's something else we can apparently do, and he just jumped over that chair. Okay, that's interesting. Let's just... Because I don't know why. I want to see how dark I can make his house. And if it's going to annoy him or not. It won't. The NPC doesn't actually take notice of the lower light level at all. But, you know, it's funny, I think. Oh, okay. Oh, one more. There you go. Turn off those. Oh! Bottle caps. Just take all the money off the table here. Nice. Okay. Yeah. Let me just, quick save in case I mess up anything. Yeah, I think we got everything, so now we can go. Okay. Now that we are done with all of the thieving, we now have our proper introduction with Good Springs underway, the first town in the game, and probably actually one of the best towns in the game, in my opinion. There's just a lot going on, a lot of little things you can do here. Nothing really impactful. But hey there, you're an interesting character. Victor.
Howdy, partner. Might I say you're looking fit as a fiddle?
Mm-hmm. Thanks for digging me out of that grave. You know who those men were who attacked me? How'd you end up in Good Springs? How'd you happen to find me? I've never seen a robot like you before. Mm-hmm.
I'm a Securitron. Robco Security Model 2060B. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy.
Mm-hmm. How did you happen to find me?
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up the old bone orchard. It's all what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low. Once they had run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were, so I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
Well, thanks for that.
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need.
Mm-hmm. Do you know who those men were who attacked me?
Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town might be able to help you out with that.
Mm-hmm. And how'd you end up here?
I moseyed into town, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall. Odd. Anyway, it's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any.
Uh-huh. All right.
Happy trails!
See you later, Victor. Yeah, I won't really spoil what his deal is, but if you don't trust him, then I don't blame you at all. I don't trust his ass either. I never liked Victor. Now, there's the Prospector Saloon. I'm sort of getting ahead of myself. Doc Mitchell told us to go to the Prospector Saloon and talk to Sunny Smiles. And, well, you know, if this was a blind playthrough, I'd have to walk up and look at all the stuff, but I sort of just walked over here automatically knowing what it was, because unfortunately I've played this game before. Oh, well. Hey, Easy Pete. Let's talk to him as well.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
Do you know anything about the people who attacked me?
The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots. That's as much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though, if you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted, I'd say.
Why are you called Easy Pete?
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now, we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and Bighorners.
Huh. You're a prospector, like a... digging for gold and silver? What's wrong with the NCR? Let's ask that first.
Don't get me wrong. The NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them whether you like it or not. Towns like Good Springs and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion awake.
Mm-hmm. You were a prospector, like digging for gold and silver?
Nah. Means I poked through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never liked the term. The way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it.
Mm-hmm. Did you ever find anything good while prospecting?
Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out.
Tell me about the Legion.
They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar, or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it. A couple of years ago, they tried to take over Hoover Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them.
Mm-hmm. That would sure be a pain in the ass. What's so important about Hoover Dam? This guy's... I forgot how much of a, like, lore dump Easy Pete is. Huh. Not that I'm complaining. I love when there's a character at the beginning of the game who can just tell you everything about the current events of the world. But, yeah, I didn't realize it was him.
The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory.
Uh-huh. Clean water, that sounds like a... awfully important commodity. Important enough to be the entire plot of Fallout 3. What do you use the bighorners for? That's a kind of a dumb question, but we'll go ahead.
Eat and hide, mostly. Can't put a pack on them. You just lay down until you take it off. Can find a bunch of wild ones high up in the hills, but gotta be careful around them. They can put up a decent fight if cornered.
Mm-hmm. You know anything about Victor?
The machine? No matter what Trudy says, she thinks it's hiding something, but I think it's just a broken down relic with no place to be.
You are the expert. Used to be a prospector.
Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
Oh, critters. Oh yeah, that's those critters. We'll see them soon enough. Maybe not in this episode, but soon enough. And, those critters are another reason I might end up using a bit of VATS. Yes, indeed. Small and quick, pretty quick moving.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry. She won't bite unless I tell her to.
Oh, well, that's good. I need to get to Prim. Can you suggest a route?
Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town till it hits the freeway. Prim is the town with the roller coaster straight south. Can't miss it. NCR patrols do a good job of keeping the highway clear, but I'd keep your gun where you can reach it easily. You never know who you'll run into. Off the road, you'll probably start running into hostile wildlife. My advice would be to stick to the highway when you can.
Sure. We're not going to do this just yet because I want to go talk to some of the other people in the bar. A little short in caps, I suppose. There's any work available. What do you do around here?
I hunt geckos mostly. The meat's pretty good, and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the areas around Good Springs.
Sure. What do you want to know?
What are the towns nearby?
Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it. Since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town, the NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot.
Mm-hmm. NCR?
The New California Republic. Bunch of settlers and soldiers coming in from the west, fixing on making Nevada their own. They can be right pushy, but the roads are safer because of them, so I tend to let it go. Not that I got a choice.
That's pretty true. What does the NCR keep safe from?
Well, the wildlife for one thing, rowdy locals for another. They're protecting their own. Just happens to help us. They've been holding off this other group from the east, too.
Mm-hmm. What do you know about the other group?
Got a funny name. Call themselves Caesar's Legion. Never seen them in these parts, so I couldn't tell you much. I hear rumors, that's about it. Supposedly, they keep slaves and they got some real nasty ways of killing folks. But maybe that's just something folks in the NCR cooked up to make themselves seem more useful here. Less uninvited.
Hmm. Bit of a conspiracy possibility going on. What kind of creatures out there?
Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty bite. I've heard about bigger, nastier versions out in the wasteland, but I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous.
Mm-hmm. That's all I wanted to know. Let's talk about something else.
If you want to know anything else, just ask.
Yep. Goodbye. For now.
Until next time.
Mm-hmm. Alright. Anything else? Oh, Trudy's not here. You're a generic NPC. You have nothing to say. I don't suppose Trudy's in the back. Nope. Doesn't seem like it. She might be in here. Oh. She might be in here. Oh, this doesn't... don't know why I repeated that. I was looking for the door. Not really her at that point. Alright, I'm hidden. They won't catch me. Salesman Weekly. Meeting people. Let's take all the Sunset Sarsaparilla. Let's open this desk, see what's in it. More Sunset Sarsaparilla. Ugh. I cannot, speak English today, apparently. Locked easy. Does that mean I can... I think I have 25... Yeah, I know how to do this, thanks. I think I have 25 science, so I... Yeah. That's good. I can do this. This is all good. Alright, let's just... I might... I don't know what I'm going to do about terminals, because I'm going to be doing a lot of hacking in this playthrough. Allowance replenished. Fuck, I shouldn't have used that one. Oh, well. I mentioned earlier my character is going to be intentionally kind of bad at fighting, just because I'm going to be mostly focused on non-combat methods to overcoming obstacles in this playthrough with this particular character. But there is going to be some combat, and I am going to level up my gun skill eventually. I'll be using small weapons, small ballistic guns, I mean. But when it comes to hacking terminals in particular, there's not, frankly, I don't think this makes for an interesting, viewing experience, and I know I don't enjoy the hacking game, so it's kind of hard to, like, talk over it and actually make, conversation, but, yeah, remove as many duds as we can. But I'm going to be doing a lot of this. I don't know. If anybody wants to leave a comment and just, like, say, hey, just cut out all of the stupid, oh, awesome. Got on the first try. That's lucky. Just cut out all the stupid, hacking minigames. Then I'll probably do that. Security's our security. Welcome user. Disengage lock. Huh. What did that unlock? Not the door. That's locked, and that wouldn't make sense. Whiskey. Scotch. Dirty water. Oh! Floor safe. I bet that's what it unlocked. Sure is. 20 gauge rounds. Nice. Bottle caps. Caravan shotgun. Drained small energy cell. That doesn't have any value, so I'm not going to take that. Energy cells, those have some value, and they're not super heavy, so I'll take those. Hole, 20 gauge, plasma pistol. Yeah, might as well. Baseball butter knife, that's not a weapon. Okay. Alright, cool. Good stuff. Real good. Oh, more Sunset Sarsaparilla. I don't think these serve a purpose. I do have a mod installed, which allows me to, use empty water bottles and refill them with water in order to make them turn into dirty water bottles. And anytime you drink a water bottle, there's a random chance of the bottle breaking or going into your inventory as an empty water bottle. Which, of course, the bottle breaking doesn't make any sense, but it would be kind of overpowered if you could just always automatically... How am I hidden in this situation? I guess the guy just looked away. Alright, bring up the cursor again. Yeah, he just looked a bit to the left. Cool. Well, I guess it's good that I wanted to take that now, because it probably would have been much harder to take that while Trudy was watching. Oh well, okay, back to you, Sunny Smiles.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Oh, but yeah, what I meant to say was the whole mod with refilling your water bottles would be kind of overpowered if you could do that with every single bottle and always kept them, so the fact that they disappear sometimes is good, I think. Doc Mitchell said he could teach me to survive in the desert. Caps, don't suppose any work available.
Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the schoolhouse. Most of what's in there is junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot at it, take these.
Sure, a magazine on locksmiths.
If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need.
Mm-hmm, and the bobby pins?
You'll need those to pick the lock. Be careful, though. Put too much pressure on them, and they'll snap.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'll go and take a look at that safe when I have a chance.
Always happy to help someone down on their luck.
All right. Actually, I'm going to do that first, because it should be less time-consuming than her little teaching me to survive in the wasteland thing. Sorry. Had some gas there. Alright, let's bring up the Pip-Boy real quick. Go to weapons. Oh, apparel. Oh, I still got the vault suit. Okay. Let me, plasma pistol. Damage, go back to the damage, please. 8. Okay, laser pistol, damage 3. Caravan shotgun, that's gonna probably do more. 4. 9mm pistol. 5. And that's 8 as well. Okay, let's use the plasma pistol. Because, I'm not gonna be using energy weapons with this character. But, for the beginning of the game, it doesn't really matter what weapon I use, because all of my skills are low. So I can use an energy weapon just as effectively as a small gun, just as effectively as explosives. That's actually another reason that I chose to do like a non-combat character. This isn't going to be a pacifist playthrough, but it's going to be a playthrough where I attempt to avoid combat as much as possible. Though, of course, it's a big open world shoot 'em up game. There's still going to be lots of combat. Ooh, hey. Take that. Oh, these ones haven't grown out yet, I guess. I thought there were supposed to be some bugs outside. Huh. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm super duper wrong. Oh well. Okay, there's that front door and there's a side door. I think the side door is a bit safer to go in. Xander roots. Those are very useful. Yeah, when you go in the front door, I think you're, like, immediately met with the bugs. But yeah, no, so it's basically going to be, like, a playthrough where I try to sort of avoid combat as much as possible and resolve quests peacefully and things like that. Just because I've never done a playthrough like that in the game before, and I think it should be pretty fun. But another reason why this is advantageous is because, oh, jammed. Whoops. Awesome. And this doesn't seem to make much noise, so I should be able to take out a few more of them. I won't be able to hit him through the chairs. Uh-oh. Nope. Couldn't do it. Oh, this is like killing him in one shot, I think. Whoa, 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 whoa. How is this missing? Jesus. Alright. That's time, I guess. Like I said, small... Yeah, shut up. I know how to use vats. God damn. Yeah, like I said, small hard to hit. Where's that 95%? What's that? This is the torso. That's 48%. Head. Legs. Right arm? The right arm is a 95% chance? Okay, sure. Alright. Again. Nice, wow. I mean, I am in, like, point-blank range, so I guess it makes some sense. Alright, everything's dead? Yes, cool. I'm glad I got rid of so many of them. Yeah, aiming is gonna be a real problem, because with that, that's worth a pretty penny. And that is, too. That doesn't weigh anything. But yeah, aiming is going to be a bit of a problem because of the Denton aiming mod, or Deus Ex weapon spread mod that I've got installed. I love it. It's like one of my favorite mods in the world, because it makes it so that your weapons are like 100% accurate and will always shoot exactly where the reticle is pointed, but your character's actual ability to handle the weapon is hampered if you have a low weapon skill, because your aim wobbles all over the place. Wonder glue. I believe that's something I want, because I think I can repair items with that. Again, another mod I have installed. Tin can, toy car, no thank you. I think tin cans can also be used for fixing things, but only things made of metal. I don't have anything like that. Scrap metal as well, same deal. I don't know, I've got enough Programmer's Digest. Yeah, I've got enough, Antis Egg, yes, thank you. Thank you very much. I've got enough inventory weight. I suppose I can take one or two of them. I'm just not sure on the tin can, so I'm not going to take that in case it's not a repair item. Then I don't want that. With my luck, it'll be sitting in my inventory forever, and I'll eventually pick up a metal item. And by the time I do find a metal item, I'll have forgotten that I have the tin can in my inventory. But I won't forget about the scrap metal, because I'm 100% sure that is a item usable for repairing with the mod that I have. I've got a lot of mods installed, and I'm basically just kind of winging it. I'm gonna sort of just, you know, as I go, point out mods when they become relevant. Oh, whoops. Damn it! Stop doing that. Salesman Weekly, another one, really? Large ruined book. Okay, metal container, cherry bombs, thank you. So I hope you all don't mind my, rambling about that. Okay, let's do this first. Oh, I don't have enough lockpick. Huh. Isn't that affected by agility? I took 7 agility. How do I not have 25 of that already? Stats. Skills. Lockpick is 20. Huh, okay, well, I shouldn't have put that down. Let's go to aid. I do have that that book, Locksmith's Reader, lockpick plus 10. Alright. Yeah, WASD and mouse rotate the bobby pin. Right, okay. Awesome. Yes, picking locks is cybernetic surgery standard edition. Oh, fuck that. That's another part of the stupid cybernetic implants mod part of Project Nevada. Mentats, Primo Money, Stealth Boy, Super Stimpak. Okay. Yeah, picking locks is a lot more pleasant than hacking terminals, so I'm going to be doing more of that and less of the terminals. Oh no, I already looked in that one. It had the toy car and the other thing in it. Okay. Alright, let's go out, and we've got plenty of items. We've got some guns, some ammo. Take a look over in this abandoned little building. Oh, check out the mailbox. Programmer's Digest, see? Yeah, you can always find good things in other people's mailboxes. Go ahead, kids. Just look in other people's mailboxes. Take whatever you find. It's probably useful. You need it to survive. Just keep telling yourself that. But yeah, no. So yeah, we've got lots of new items. We've got a few things accomplished, I think, in this episode. So I think it's a good place to stop. And in the next one, if I can find my way back to... There's the saloon. It's the one with the neon sign on the front. You're just a generic NPC, right?
Hey there. If you're looking for supplies, chat over at the general store can help you out.
Hmm, the general store, huh? Sure will. Oh, none of these have grown in yet. Can't steal his maze. Oh well. But anyway, yeah. So I think that's a good place to stop. The episode should be about 50 minutes long, I think. Something like that. And when we come back, we will go and talk to Sunny Smiles. Maybe check out the Good Springs General Store before we go, just to sell off some things and free up inventory space. Yeah, that's actually what we'll do next. We'll go to the Good Springs General Store, sell off some things, then go and talk to Sunny Smiles and have her teach us how to survive in the wasteland. So, yep, that was Fallout New Vegas. I hope you all enjoyed it. I'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.